Hardy Diagnostics makes several products that utilize fluorescence for the detection and identification of microorganisms. The use of fluorescent compounds in culture media aids in screening and detection due to the metabolism of fluorescent substrates from certain species of bacteria or fungi. In this video, we will explain the procedure for reading fluorescence on our chromogenic media products from various target organisms. As an example, we will initially examine colonies growing on Hardychrome candida plus oris. We will also name the common pitfalls in reading fluorescence. To begin, ensure that you allow the petri plates to warm to room temperature before inoculation. The surface of the plates should also be dry. Inoculate and streak the patient's specimen as soon as possible after collection. Use a 4-quadrant streak to obtain well-isolated colonies. If the specimen to be cultured is on a swab, roll the swab over a small area of the auger surface. Then streak for isolation with a sterile loop. Incubate the plates in an inverted position and place them in an aerobic incubator at 35 degrees Celsius. Make sure that the plates are protected from light, and also make sure there is a source of water in the incubator to increase the level of humidity. Remove the plates from the incubator after 24 hours of incubation to observe colony morphology. Isolated colonies of Candida auris may or may not have developed color after 24 hours. Under visual ambient light, typical Candida auris colonies will develop a teal to teal green bullseye pattern. If a teal to teal green bullseye pattern is present, check for fluorescence under UV light. In most cases, it will take at least 48 hours to obtain good pigment and fluorescent development. Make sure you are using a UV lamp with a wavelength of 365 nanometers, such as the ones shown here. You can either turn the lights off in the room or leave the lights on and use a dark viewing box to observe fluorescence. The environment must be dark to properly view fluorescence. If using a UV light, such as the LSS3 UV flashlight, hold the light directly over isolated colonies on the plate, approximately 3 to 4 inches or 7 to 10 centimeters away. In this case, the isolated colonies of Candida auris will fluoresce a greenish white. In instances where Candida auris is suspected, it is recommended to incubate plates up to 72 hours to observe fluorescence, as well as the typical teal to teal green bullseye morphology under ambient room light. If using a viewing box and a UV lamp, place the UV lamp in the proper position on the box. Ensure the lamp is plugged in and turned to the on position. Place your plates in the viewing box and look through the viewing window to observe fluorescence. Check fluorescence if teal to teal green bullseye colonies are observed within 48 to 72 hours of incubation. Under regular room light, the colonies of Candida auris will go from a white to a teal-colored bullseye at the center of the colony to completely teal. As the color develops, the fluorescence will fade. Plates can be incubated for up to 72 hours. After 72 hours, plates should be discarded. Caution! There are many cheaper UV handheld flashlights available on the internet. We have tested most of them in our laboratory and found all of them not to be adequate for microbiological purposes. The one exception is the one shown here, which is our catalog number LSS3. All of the others, although cheaper, are of low wattage and will not produce a UV light of adequate intensity and the correct wavelength to reliably detect colony fluorescence. Hardy Diagnostics makes other products that utilize fluorescence, such as Hardychrome Vibrio, Hardychrome Vibrio is used for the cultivation, isolation, and differentiation of Vibrio species from food and environmental samples. Vibrio cholera can be differentiated from Vibrio vulnificus by fluorescence. Vibrio vulnificus will fluoresce blue under UV light, and Vibrio cholera will not fluoresce under UV light. BCYE products are another group of products that exhibit fluorescence. Colonies of Legionella pneumophila will fluoresce yellow-green under UV light. Colonies of Legionella bosemaniae, formerly Legionella bosemanii, will also fluoresce blue-white under UV light. Colonies of Legionella mcdadii will not fluoresce. Since Legionella are slow-growing organisms, it can take 48 to 96 hours to observe growth and fluorescence. Products containing MUG, such as EC Medium with MUG, Violet Red Bile Auger with MUG, Laurel Tryptose with MUG, McConkie with MUG, and MUG or MOT discs also utilize fluorescence. MUG is the acronym for methyl umbilliferol glucuronide. These products are used to detect E. coli from food and water samples. For all of the products mentioned in this video, it is important to first read the instructions for use in order to make the correct interpretation of the results. All of our IFUs can be found in the products section of our website, hardydiagnostics.com. As we have demonstrated in this video, fluorescence is a very useful and simple tool to help in the detection and speciation of various types of bacteria and yeast. As a provider of microbiology products, Hardy Diagnostics offers all of the materials and equipment shown in this video. This video is a supplement, not a replacement, to the full instructions for use. For the full instructions for use or for more information, please visit our website at hardydiagnostics.com.
Hardy Diagnostics is your complete microbiology supplier. Check out our catalogs in the links below. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more tutorials and product videos. Remember to turn on notifications to be notified of new videos as they are released. Hardy Diagnostics is 100% employee owned and has been serving microbiologists for over 40 years. To learn more about Hardy Diagnostics and the products we offer, visit us at hardydiagnostics.com.